The Jawaharlal Nehru Centre for Advanced Scientific Research (JNCASR) is a multidisciplinary research institute located at Jakka, Bangalore, India. It was established by the Department of Science and Technology of the Government of India, to mark the birth centenary of Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Academics. Researchers at the center are divided into 7 units: chemistry and physics of materials, engineering mechanics, evolutionary and organismal biology, molecular biology and genetics, new chemistry, theoretical sciences, educational technology and geodynamics. There are 2 off-campus units, chemical biology and condensed matter theory. JNCASR has a faculty-to-student ratio of about 1 to 4 and state-of-the-art experimental, computational and infrastructural facilities. It offers PhD programs, as well as an integrated PhD post-bachelor's degree program in materials science. It is a deemed university, i.e., it awards its own degrees. Apart from training its own students through a wide spectrum of courses, JNCASR actively supports a range of education outreach activities. For example, every year the center's Summer Research Fellowship Program hosts some of the very brightest undergraduates in the country. The Educational Technology Unit produces a range of teaching aids and educational material. The center also organizes and teaches short-term courses at universities across India, and promising young chemists and biologists are trained intensively as part of the programs of Project-Oriented Chemical Education (POCE) and Project-Oriented Biological Education (POBE). Topic: collaboration and research. The small size of the institute, currently about 53 faculty members and approximately 300 students, has many advantages. It fosters interdisciplinary collaborations that might not have sprung up at larger institutions where researchers are segregated in far-flung labs. Amongst the many such on-campus collaborations that have sprung up over the years, a fluid dynamicist has joined forces with a statistical mechanician to look at flow in nanochannels with an experimental physicist to study the freezing of laser-induced metal droplets when they impinge on a substrate, a theoretical molecular dynamics study of the arrangement of water molecules around a protein has emerged from coffee table discussions between a biochemist and physicist, and a many-body theorist is modeling the devices developed in the molecular electronics lab. In the last few years, the center's faculty members have published their research in some of the most prestigious scientific journals, including Nature, Nature Medicine, Science, Evolution, the Journal of the American Chemical Society, Angewandte Chemie, the Journal of Fluid Mechanics, and Physical Review Letters. JNCASR contributes about 200 journal papers a year. The work of the center's faculty has been recognized by awards. The list of honors and prizes received by CNR Rao runs into many pages. To list just a few of the awards gained by other faculty members, in 2006, Tapas Kumar Kundu was awarded the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award for Biological Sciences, Anaranjan Anand received the Outstanding Research Award from the Department of Atomic Energy, India, and Srikant Sastri, G.U. Kulkarni and Balasubramanian Sundaram received the B.M. Birla Science Prize. In 2007, Rama Govindarajan was one of the recipient of Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award. In 2010, Swapan Kumar Patti and Umeshwamare received Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Award, Manisha S. Inamdar was awarded the National Bioscience Award for Career Development in 2011. The institute has received 12 patents from various countries as of November 2013. It is recognized as highest impact institution based on Science Citation Index for 2010-11. As of March 2014, the institute is planning to have a supercomputer for materials research, forensic engineering and failure analysis. Topic: administration. As of 2017, V. Nagaraja is the president of JNCASR. Topic: campus. The architecturally innovative buildings on the campus blend inobtrusively into several acres of lush landscape, with only the Buckyball Dome, designed by Charles Corrier, rising above the treetops. The institute has a HIV research lab dedicated to the study of subtype C and its global dominance.